Congratulations on your Harmany Muzzle purchase. Your horse is on his way to becoming happier and healthier. Today I'm going to show you how you can mold your Harmany Muzzle using something that we probably all have. It's a hairdryer. Using an 1800 watt hairdryer, you have everything you need to customize your Harmany Muzzle to fit your horse's head shape. On standby, we'll also have some water. I have a dish of water here, just so we can cool the plastic once we mold it. Are you ready? Get your hairdryer, let's go. First, we're just gonna turn on the hairdryer. And then we'll target the hairdryer to the point of the muzzle that you would like to mold. I'm starting with a totally flat muzzle. So the first thing that I'm going to do is pick a line and concentrate on it. Make sure that you are on the highest heat setting and the fan is on the highest as well. The plastic is already getting a little warm. So what I want you to do every few seconds is flip over and direct the heat to the other side. That I'm holding my muzzle so that gravity would be able to do the work once it becomes pliable. We're getting there. But once the plastic is ready to bend, this flap will just automatically bend down. So we're going to let gravity do the work. Ever so often, you'll want to kind of give it a feel just to see where you are. We are almost there. You'll know you're there because the muzzle will start to bend at the seam, making your job a lot easier. All right, it looks like we're there. At this point, bend it to the angle that will best suit your horse's head shape. I started with the cheek piece, but if you started with the front, keep that in mind. You want to be able to accommodate your horse's nose. Bend it to however would best suit your horse, and then dunk it down in the water, not for too terribly long, just long enough to let that plastic cool. If you don't have a big pan of water, a water bucket will be just fine if you're doing this at the barn. And you'll see that was probably 10 or 15 seconds, and my muzzle has cooled. So now we're ready to do another side. You'll see that my hairdryer has a tapered diffuser on the end. This comes in handy because it allows you to target your heat wherever you want it on your muzzle. Again, let gravity be your guide. When you note that the side of the muzzle starts to droop a little bit, that's your cue that it's ready for you to mold. So again, I'm just going to take this side and mold it up to where it'll fit my horse. And then I'm going to dunk it down in the cool water to set the mold. And again, it does not take long to set the mold. The key is just to make sure that your cool water touches all the areas that you want to form. And again, we're done. And that was only about 10 seconds. Now we'll do the front and the sides. Okay, remember, the part that is stamped Harmany Muzzles goes on the front. That's your nose piece. So when you go to mold that, like we are right now, think about the way your horse's nose is. Is it super dished? I don't know. I have a horse that has a Roman nose, so that's probably what I'm going to go for right now. Remember, let gravity be your guide. I see that we're ready. So I'm going to go ahead and bend this like so, and I'm going to put it in our cool water. All right, now we're ready for our chin piece. Now, something else that you want to remember is that all pieces and parts of this grazing muzzle are customizable. So if you have a horse that has a big chin, for example, you can take your hair dryer and you can direct it right here once you get the flap folded in and cooled down. You can mold this part as well. Keep in mind that your Harmany muzzle can be molded as many times as you'd like. So if you notice that your horse is getting a rubbed spot or does need a little more room in the chin area, you can heat it right back up using your hair dryer, using the same method, and you can make as many customizations as you need. All right, and remember, you know this by now, let gravity be your guide. So, since it's starting to flop, I'm going to go ahead and bend up and dunk in my cool water. All right, your Harmany muzzle is ready to go. Unless, of course, you would like to dictate the amount of grass that your horse gets. You can do that by choosing to punch out the tabs in the bottom of the muzzle. You can use something as simple as a pair of dikes or fence pliers, or you can use a sharp knife. Just be very careful. You can also, at this point, choose to bend out the tabs using the same method that I just showed you with the hair dryer. If you want to bypass those steps and you're ready to throw this on your horse, you can use the enclosed Velcro straps, run the rows through the slots, and then attach to any breakaway halter. Remember, we have a specially designed Harmany Muzzles halter that fits beautifully with this muzzle. Check it out on the website. It's www.harmanymuzzle.com. Thank you so much for helping me mold this muzzle, and if you have any questions, please check us out on our website at www.harmanymuzzle.com.